Namaskar friends, the book for today is My Princely Colleges by Harkishan Lal Dutt, better known as Mr. H.L. Dutt. Mr. H.L. Dutt happens to be my college teacher, my guru, and the erstwhile principal of Colvin Talukdar's College, Lucknow, where I studied. He taught me English. I still remember the splendor of his English class, especially that of Shakespeare's Merchant of Venice in 1974-35, that is still etched like the sparkle of a diamond in my mind, where even the onslaught of time has not been able to faint it in any manner. And I remember one of Merchant of Venice's very important lines. It is a wise father that knows his own child, says Lancelot in Act 2, Scene 2 of Merchant of Venice. Mr. Dutt knew each student like his father, most certainly one of the best English teachers I have ever known, erudite, handsome, with a tall pedigree and an appropriate convent English accent, something that everyone envied those days. The manner in which he monitored college reminds me of another quote from Merchant of Venice: young in limbs, in judgment old. This is by Morocco in Act 2, Scene 7. So he looked very young even when he joined the college, I can recollect now, but he was hands-on, and his judgments in bringing up the college were very good. Anyway, the publishers of this book are Notion Press. They have done a good job. The author dedicates the book to his wife, Bina Dutt, his Rock of Gibraltar, his daughters, Alka and Anu, and his son, Harsh. The price of the book is ₹450 for a print copy and ₹60 for a Kindle one. The book is a personal account of Mr. H.L. Dutt, his autobiography, a book I would recommend to teachers and students especially. It is a 161-page book constructed over 28 chapters describing the journey of his career life, and thereafter his retreat, his retirement that he is now into enjoying. The book starts with the chapter Destiny, his early days, his outdoors and his co-curricular activities. Then the scene changes. This was in Mayo College, Ajmer. Then the scene changes to England, where he goes for a Bartseri, acquires a foreign degree, and then returns to Mayo College, Ajmer again, where he teaches for a good number of years and then bids adieu in the year 1966, looking for a wider exposure in terms of his career. He then joins Cambridge School, followed by Pilani, and then he marches into Colvin Talukdar's College, Lucknow. He further goes on to teach in Hyderabad Public School, the Daily College, Indore, and then returns to Mayo College, Ajmer again, and even starts Mayo College Girls School. In short, Mr. Dutt started his teaching career from Mayo College, Ajmer, in 1954. He had splendid days there, full of learnings and excitement. He gives a very animated account of his stay in Mayo, Ajmer, that includes a plethora of campus activities, excursions, sighting of animals, and even shikar. Can you beat it? When it was permitted. Mayo in those times was a princely college, with children of most princely states of India studying there. He then talks of various college houses like Bharatpur House, Udaipur House, Jhalawar House, Jaisalmer House, Kota House, and even talks about his campus accommodation. After leaving Mayo in 1966, he joined Cambridge School, Delhi, followed by Pilani, and then Colvin Talukdar's College, spread over 99 acres of campus on the banks of River Gomti. In Colvin, he took over from Principal H.N. Kashyap. Reading about Colvin was indeed nostalgic, as I had studied there. The author has given quite a detailed account of his tenure in Colvin, Lucknow. He starts with the titling of Lucknow as the city of Nawabs. He then goes on to describe college houses such as Hind, Anjuban, Awadh, Takshila, the celebrations of Janmashtami, and he hasn't forgotten the Nawabs of and the Rajas and the Talukdars of Uttar Pradesh, such as Raja of Oil, Mankapur, Kotwara, Pratapgarh, Amethi, Kala Kankar, Bhinga, and Mahmudabad. He highlights the tandoori chicken, kebabs, and rumali roti, and the dinner invitation of Raja Sajid Hussain of Kotwara. The author vividly remembers Mrs. Seely, headmistress of the junior school, then faculty L.P. Bharadwaj, and the senior master P.C. Chauvey. Colvin indeed was a powerhouse of academics, producing IITians, doctors, and bureaucrats galore. Some unforgettable sportsmen that he remembers, and he has a good memory, I must say, are Hamidullah, Birbal, Razdan, and Puri. Then he also remembers ace debaters like Trivedi, Pandey, Sharma brothers, Laktakia, and Lovekush Verma, and of course, Ashok Prasad and head prefect Satnam Singh. He also hasn't forgotten many old teachers of Colvin, such as S.N. Tandon, S.B. Singh, Samiullah, Amanatullah, Sudhir Dayal, Jayaswal, G.V. Singh, and Brinda Shankar. He fondly remembers his exquisite bungalow and even his gardeners, and the flowers out there, and the famous Darbar Day, the busiest day of the college, and the old boys and their parents, who were very close to Mr. Dutt, I suppose. An interesting point that author makes is that he found certain names, starting with the letter A, to be more prominent in class and academics, such as Alok, Ashok, Anil, Arun, Arunendra. In the process, in no way he disparages other letters. The author then goes on to narrate his experience of Hyderabad public school. In June 1979, he takes up a new assignment, the Daily College, Indore, a princely college that was built by princes of Malwa. Finally, the author returns to Mayo College, Ajmer, with a great amount of nostalgia. The book also covers his starting of Mayo Girls College. But the author's career cycle is yet not complete. Then in 2006, Mr. Dutt is invited by Dr. Sanjay Singh, Raja Amethi, to head the college once again to bring back its glory at the age of 76, which he does. So, Mr. Dutt returns to Colvin after many years. Now, after which, after setting the college right, Mr. H.L. Dutt takes his final retirement and settles in Gurgaon. His contribution to public colleges shall always be remembered. He stood for excellence, and he was an outstanding leader and a true Karam Yogi, I would say. Although I know I'm too small to say anything for him, but I still feel he was a Karam Yogi. Friends, before I close this book, let me tell you, the book is a treat to read. And I'm not saying this just because the author happens to be my guru or principal. What I liked about the book was the segmentation and presentation of the text in small chapters, where emotions of the author were captured very well and without being obvious. The author made his points in a very sly manner. He has used plain but enticing English, keeping students in mind, and has desisted from verbosity. The sentences are soothing, pleasing, and inviting, where you don't feel like putting down the book. I would say it's a real page turner. I once again repeat that most of you should pick up this book and go through it. It'll give you a good amount of nostalgia. And I wish Mr. Dutt good health and a very happy retired life. So friends, that's all for today. Goodbye and see you soon.